gang members. Police and lawyers are among those set to make submissions at a parliamentary select committee on the proposed new gang laws. The legislation would see gang patches banned and police given extra powers to stop gang members from congregating. Criminal lawyer Arama Ngapo is making a submission on behalf of people associated with the Mongrel Mob. And she joins us live from Tokoroa. Morena, Arama.
Atamaria, Daniel. How are you?
I'm really, really good. Thank you for joining us this morning. I'm just going through your submission on behalf of women and children associated with the Mongrel Mob, but your submission doesn't specifically mention this. Can you just clarify?
Sure. Well, earlier when I was talking to Anna about this issue, it's my position that this is a wider Bill of Rights issue that will affect everybody in New Zealand, not just those that are associated with the Mongrel Mob. It is very much a freedom of association issue and a Bill of Rights issue.
So how will these impact women and children associated with the Mongrel Mob?
Well, there are three parts to the proposed legislation. The first part is about the prohibition of gang insignia being displayed in public. The second are dispersal notices, and the third is the non-consorting orders. Now, they're very similar to non-association orders, that if the court or the police identify that you are an associated person with someone in a gang, then you're not allowed to associate with them. And my submissions, I go over examples if there was a tangihanga or a funeral on a marae, and there was a non-consorting order in place that would actually prevent you from being able to grieve with your whānau or family, Daniel.
Arama, the government says, and you'll know this, this is all about safety. These proposed laws are about seeing gangs are out of control, they cause crime, and they even point to Western Australia and Queensland and look at their tough anti-gang laws. Doesn't imposing stricter conditions make New Zealand safer?
I think the real concern is asking the police to become fashion police. And with the gang insignia, that's exactly what we're asking our already overstretched, overburdened and underpaid police force to do. We are literally saying to them, if you see someone wearing an insignia that's in the particular list that may be a gang insignia, we want you to take action. And it's already been raised earlier on that the police simply don't have the resources to patrol or police this type of offending. And whilst the government says they want to get tough on crime, and we all know what the coalition agreement says, the actual impact of such legislation isn't going to work. And what I really want to see the government show us is research-based data and evidence that shows that this type of draconian legislation actually works.
Arama, I just want to continue with you speaking about this government wanting to keep the public safe. You would have heard it's bringing back the three strikes. What's your view on that?
The three strikes legislation was repealed earlier because, again, it didn't work. It also targeted Māori people unfairly and those that had particular mental health issues. And because the judiciary's hands were tied, there were circumstances where people who had mental health issues were actually being sent to jail when that wasn't the appropriate place for them.
Arama Ngapo, as always, good to talk to you. Thank you so much for your time this morning.
Thank you.